Everyone loves a hero. Citizen Kane, the iconic film co-written, produced, and directed by Orson Welles. It is a film mentioned on every list of great films, often at the top. Citizen Kane, bandied about in film school hallways, referenced in nearly every film text, and yet, maybe not seen by as many people as you would think.
Pictures up.
We're rolling.
Rolling.
Speed.
Rolling.
Ready, slate.
Scene 7A, take one, marker.
Action.
Now, Casablanca. Everyone's seen Casablanca. Or at least they say they have. Every sound an actor makes in a feature film is replaced by the Foley artist. And the process of recreating these sounds is called Foley. And it's a ton of fun. For instance, you could take that murderous sound that I was making with a cabbage and a knife and use the same instruments to do a cooking segment with a tomato. All of these sounds, while they look real, are created by the Foley artist. They layer them in one by one. For instance, in this scene, we might do Foley of a chain gang. And the first layer would be to figure out how the chains are going to match with the man walking. The next layer might be the man's footsteps. The third layer might be screaming in the background. Or we might do something more subtle. For instance, on the beach. What if I had to replace these sounds, footstep by footstep in the sand? Stop. Wait for it. The beautiful turn. And of course, we would also be adding in.
This is Houston, say again, please.
Houston, we have a problem.
You may recognize that line from the movie Apollo 13, written by William Broyles Jr. and Al Reinert, and directed by Ron Howard. Of course, the movie's based on the real-life drama surrounding the Apollo 13 spacecraft emergency of 1970.
In an attempt to return to the moon, three NASA astronauts were left nearly powerless in space after an oxygen tank exploded. Then, for 3 days, the astronauts and NASA fight to keep the astronauts alive and bring them back to Earth. It's a great story and a great film with a great tagline. Houston, we have a problem.
The problem is Examples abound. Movies like, and I'm going to tell them to you alphabetically off the top of my head. How about Blade Runner, Dead
Poets Society, Diner, Escape from Alcatraz, Hoosiers, Jeremiah Johnson's Movie, 28 Days Later, Sign Up, Alien, Some Like It, Harry Potter, Louise, Rise of the Condor. How about Lion, Slay, Goblin, 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 Goblin,
And that's computer generated. A computer generated image, or CGI for short. The actors never see the fire, and they never really feel the heat of the flame, because for all practical purposes, it's not there. For instance, a green screen. If you're not familiar, think weather map on the nightly news. The weather person isn't actually standing in front of a real map. They're actually standing in front of a screen like this one, painted a specific shade of green, a chroma green. And because the green on this screen is such a specific color, a computer is able to recognize that color and remove every speck of it, replacing it with something else, like a map. Earth explodes at 10, news at 11. A tomb with the Holy Grail.
I've chosen wisely.
Or a planet in a galaxy far, far away.
Over here!
That's called green screen. We'll pick it up here in part two as we move into the 21st century.